Thank you. please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
And remain standing for the National Anthem and Alma Mater.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say, can you see? So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight are the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Good morning, and welcome to Sycamore High School's graduation ceremony. My name is Elena Berry, and I'm the Executive President of SHS. I will be the Master of Ceremonies today, and I'm so excited and honored to join everyone in celebrating the class of 2018. First of all, thank you friends, family, staff, and administration for supporting us today and every day for the past 13 years of school. Thank you for helping shape us into the people we are and for fighting for our future. We owe who we are to the people in this room. Today we celebrate how far we have come in the beginning of each one of our journeys. When I think of my time at Sycamore, I think of opportunity, family, and spirit. I think of the years of preparation that the faculty of Sycamore Community Schools has guided us through, and the opportunities that have been given to us. From Tea Club to Model United Nations, Sycamore has provided us every chance to succeed. I also think of teachers who have spent countless hours mentoring and tutoring. The faculty of SHS are more than just teachers, custodians, or administrators. They're family. They know our names and our stories. They care about us as human beings, not simply test scores or GPAs. Class of 2018, we have been gifted with something extraordinary. We have been given a community whose sole purpose is to help us reach our full potential, and even still, push ourselves to learn, grow, and experience more. Finally, I think of spirit. Our time at Sycamore High School has had its ups and downs. We have experienced losses and great victories. Through it all, we have grown into a class of pride and excellence. We have pride in our school and pride in who we are. Looking forward to our futures ahead of us, I am eager to see where each of our paths take us. In just a couple months, we will have a clean slate in front of us. I'm sure that life will seem scary and impossible at times. We will face many trials, but I believe with the tools we have been given and the skills we have worked for here at Sycamore, each and every one of us has a future that is bright, unique, and exciting. Class of 2018, I'm genuinely honored to have been able to learn together and experience our childhoods together. I am so proud of who we have become. We fight strongly for what we believe in, and we strive to be educated and kind. Thank you for sharing this journey with me. Cherish this time of celebration, and remember as you go off what you have learned here at Sycamore. Thank you, and go Aves. And now, senior Anita Pan for her welcome address. Excuse me, her address, what do you want to be remembered for?
Good morning, friends, family, teachers, administrators, and my fellow classmates. It just seems like yesterday we were freshmen sitting in the main auditorium on the first day of school, anxiously waiting to meet our new teachers and administrators. In our very first encounter together, they challenged us. Although we were just freshmen, they had said, we still could be leaders, whether it be through leading by example or just literally doing what you're supposed to do. So on the very first day of high school, we were faced with a question. What do you, class of 2018, want to be remembered for? And as the semesters flew by, the sentiment of this question never disappeared. Each year, we were reminded and challenged. What legacy will we leave behind? As I look at us now, I see leaders, innovators, and thinkers. I see 7 future service members of the armed forces, 21 college-bound student athletes, 32 Scholastic Key winners, 34 National Merit Scholars, 125 National Honor Society members, and 194 honor roll students. I see students who've collectively submitted 1,811 college applications, volunteers who've served over 2,155 hours on Senior Service Day, supporters who've raised over $1,600 for the Moskowitz family, entrepreneurs who created the first ever flight night and raised over $1,000 for Kids to Camp, journalists who won the National Pacemaker Award for their tireless efforts in being the voice of Sycamore, thespians who've undoubtedly put on one of the best showcases of Into the Woods, with 2 actresses winning featured awards for their transformative and electric roles, and activists who've stood for what they believed in during the student-led walkout. It is by no accident that all of these extraordinary things have happened this year. They are a result of the fact that we as a class did not surrender to the preconceived notion that age defines leadership. Because in truth, we had been setting the bar high ever since our first year at Sycamore High School. In 9th grade, we researched and created over 140 family history projects, contributed to layups for Lauren Hill, which then went on to raise over $1 million locally, placed 2nd in the GMC for chess, and beat Mason in football 36-0. In 10th grade, the varsity women's water polo placed 2nd in the state. Men's tennis won their 4th consecutive GMC title, along with the well-deserved state title. Relay for Life raised a record-breaking amount of $91,835 for cancer research and care, and Orchestra was rated superior at the state OMEA competition. In our junior year, boys soccer earned the title of GMC champion, marching band placed second in the state championship, and the men's track and field 4x2 placed first at the OHSAA state championship. I can't even list all of our accomplishments due to limited time, but all I know is that I can confidently say, class of 2018, we did that. So what do we want to be remembered for? Well, I think we have our answer. We, the class of 2018, speak up. We put in the work and we persevere. We lead by example and strive to perfect ourselves as individuals and as a team. Whether it's from tennis matches to research papers, pep rallies to senior pranks, we are all in. And that's what sets us apart from everyone else. We as a whole have left our mark on Sycamore High School, and today is the day to celebrate that. As we close out our final chapter of our high school career, we face many uncertainties in both our immediate and near future. However, uncertainty is just another word for opportunity. So with that, I want us to never lose the work ethic and passion we've developed over these 4 years. I want us to cherish our accomplishments and to remember that we are capable and deserving of every opportunity that falls before us. Congratulations, class of 2018. I am so honored to be a part of Sycamore history.
Please welcome Mr. Mader, principal of Sycamore High School, with the welcome address.
Parents, families, friends of the Sycamore community, Board of Education, Mr. Forstavel, members of our district office team, our teaching faculty, but most importantly, the class of 2018, it is with great pride I welcome you to this year's graduating ceremony, a ceremony to celebrate the class of 2018. Many graduates have come before you, class of 2018, and many of these graduates have deep roots into this community and still live here. If you are a graduate of Sycamore High School and call yourself an alumni, if you would please stand at this time to be recognized. Sycamore High School has a remarkable staff and faculty that have poured countless hours into you to challenge you to get you to this point. Sycamore High School is a very special place where we believe that building relationships and empowering students and staff is essential in developing the talented young people you have become. I ask the team of high school teachers and staff, especially those that escorted you in this morning, to please stand to be recognized. We are blessed at Sycamore because students come to us prepared to face the challenges of high school. This doesn't happen at a lot of schools, and it doesn't happen by accident. The class of 2018 know that they got here from great teachers in grades K through 8. Sycamore is a team effort. If you are a staff member in grades K through 8 in the Sycamore community, especially those seated in our reserve section off to my left, if you would please stand to be recognized. Every staff member here knows we're lucky at Sycamore because we have such a wonderful and supportive community. And we also know a good kid doesn't happen by accident. We know it takes a lot of nurturing and challenging from parents and guardians. If you are a parent or guardian of a graduate today, if you would please stand to be recognized. Class of 2018, what a special class you have become. You are set apart by how genuine and mature you are. As adults, you see sometimes teenagers can wear on us a bit. Amen. However, class of 2018, you truly are fun to be around, even after last Friday. I hope it is true what one of our counselors, Mrs. DK, said, that you were trying to show us your resilience by bouncing back, by bringing you the bouncy balls to school. She was either being serious or see if my blood pressure could actually set a new record. But seriously, you, class of 2018, you know when to have fun, you know when to socialize, and you know when to get to work. Your work is evident in the accomplishments that Anita laid out for us this morning. Know how proud we are of you. You helped cultivate a culture at Sycamore High School that is one of the best. You truly are leaders. There are a few special leaders I would like to recognize this morning. You have members of this class who are going to give of themselves to protect and serve this great country. Would the following students please stand? Timothy Guth, Heidi Howe, Noah Hughes, Sam Keller, Andrew Kern, Kyra Lee, Joe Lane, Jack Rose, Kyle Schreiber, and Austin Tornator. While you're still standing, we thank you, we honor you, but also if there are any veterans or active duty personnel in the audience, if you would also please stand to be recognized. Thank you. There are 26 nations represented in this graduating class. I would like to point one student out in particular. If Bowie Ook could stand. Bowie is originally from Myanmar. We are proud to announce that he passed his citizenship 9 short days ago. Bowie, we are proud to call you an American citizen. So after today, you are embarking on endless possibilities. I encourage you to pursue your passion. Through high school, you have had training wheels on. And now that those training wheels are coming off, you have a chance to truly find your own path. Mark Twain said, Don't let schooling get in the way of your education. You can truly achieve what you choose to achieve. You see, through choices, you can turn failure into success. Class of 2018, I have told you my story on multiple occasions. And what inspired me, besides my parents, to turn my life around was my Uncle Charlie Bentzman. His own personal turnaround was determined by choices he made. You see, he was a high school dropout. The choices he made to rectify the dropout status later in life with a high school diploma, a college degree, then a PhD, and he ended up as a college president. He was and ended his career the president of Thomas More College. Many times, making a choice forces each of us to make difficult decisions. Oftentimes, these choices are troublesome because what seems like the easy way is most aggravating to us in the end. Those choices that are most challenging usually end up with the most rewarding results. For each person here, there are choices that you must make in life when you get to that fork in the road. It's your choice to become a better version of yourself from this day forward. Please know that your words matter, your work matters, you matter. If every person made a choice to do their part to make their corner of the world better, imagine what this world could be. There is no time like the present to make the choice to make a difference in the world. We need you. So I ask that you lean on and learn from your faith, your family, and your friends, but rely on yourself and your heart. Make the choice to be you. You see, you all have inherent good inside, and you know deep down inside the right path to take. Class of 2018, you have what it takes to make the right choices and truly make a difference in this world. Thank you, class of 2018. From my heart, I will miss you. Thank you.
Now please welcome Mr. Frank Forstoffel, Superintendent of Sycamore Community Schools.
So good morning. Oh, let's try that again. Good morning. Good morning. There you go. Class of 2018, parents, families, Sycamore staff, alumni and friends, and everyone joining us from around the globe via our live stream. Graduates, what a great morning when we as a family get to celebrate you, celebrate all that you've accomplished on finishing that race, crossing that line of what we call high school, but also to dream of all that you can accomplish as proud graduates of Sycamore High School. Now, whether you joined our family as a kindergartner or graced us with your presence at some point thereafter, each and every one of you have something in common, something that will stay with you for as long as you walk this earth. Each and every one of you is an aviator. Now, your principal, Mr. Mater, and Anita did a fantastic job of sharing some of your most excellent achievements as a class. And needless to say, you represented Sycamore High School, your district, and your family with grace and distinction. With that said, you left a legacy. You left a mark on Sycamore High School. But what defined your legacy? Here are a couple of my perspectives. You've been published internationally. You've achieved nationally through DECA and TPA. You've performed on stage with a legendary rock band, and boy, was that cool, I got to see that, and a country music star. You've competed at the state level in science, song, and sport, and you've advocated for the homeless and hungry. And you stood by a classmate in the battle for his life, giving him the strength needed to take the field for 16 seconds. And most importantly, you served. Served so selflessly that you've been recognized at our nation's capital for your volunteer work. Your legacy as truly an exceptional class will be remembered long after you leave our doors and make your mark on the world. You have left a legacy to those that will follow you as future graduates of Sycamore High School. And you may have felt that overwhelming feeling of nostalgia and a sense of passing that torch when you participated in the senior walk just a few days ago. Thank you. Thank you for lighting the path for those that follow. So I know each of you probably did not have any trouble getting up this morning to get here, right? Okay. So that got me thinking about something I've been hearing about for years, this affliction called senioritis. I've heard teachers talk about it. I've heard graduates from other years talk about it, but I was never really sure exactly what it is. So it made me wonder, is it real? I've heard that one of the overriding symptoms was a complete inability to get out of bed in the morning to get to school. Now, this particular symptom of senioritis usually begins in the late winter and worsens in the spring until it reaches critical levels in late April and May. Look, they're nodding. And it culminated this year when many of you couldn't even make it to school on a certain Monday. I'm not sure what all that means, but now I have firsthand evidence that this thing called senioritis is for real. How do I know this? Well, I've lived it in my own home. A certain graduate has been having some trouble getting out of bed in the mornings. So, being the good dad that I am, I solicited a little help this week from a few of my friends. Please watch.
Get out!
Time for school!
Time for school! Get her out!
God!
Get out! If this goes anywhere, I swear to God!
So there's my evidence. I guess it's very real. Now, I have heard all great graduation speeches should have words of wisdom from the speaker, in this case me, to the graduates, you, on success. Now, I could impress you with famous quotes from people you've never heard of, or stories of resilience from figures of the past, but instead, I thought I would enlist the help of some of my dear friends who'd like to offer some advice to you on how to be successful. So please watch again.
What should you do if you're nervous or scared about going to school?
Just breathe and believe that you can do it.
Yeah. If you're nervous, then I think you should probably just believe.
Watch The Ellen Show. It always calms me down.
So how do you make friends in college?
You get to know people. So, like, you see this girl walking down the hall, you're like, hi, I'm Maya. What's your name?
Ask people if they want to be your friends.
Be nice.
What if you, like, have a roommate that's just really messy?
If they're scared of animals, you should say that there's a rat under that thing and you should really clean up or something.
How often do you think you should come home?
Every weekend.
Every weekend?
Every holiday there is.
If you're close to your parents,
maybe.
Every weekend.
At what age should you get married?
So you don't want to get married in college, because it's not a good thing.
Because
with all the work in college and stuff, it's kind not of good to have an extra mouth to feed, especially when you don't have a great job.
How do you decide what kind of job you want to have?
To do something what I like and try to inspire.
Okay.
Like, I like pets, so I would probably want to help.
And you should have a good job, that way you can like your job, you'll feel comfortable there, you can make money, and you can buy your wants and needs.
And get friends.
Get a good job and don't get fired.
Don't be like my sister.
sleep. Because that's what she did, and then she got fired.
How about those great kids? Those are future graduates. Well, I don't know much more I can add to that, but if I could offer one piece of advice, here it is. You are stepping from the families that you have found comfort in for years. Your Sycamore family has provided you the support you needed to get you to the point, this point today. And your own family has been by your side to also guide you to the cusp of the next phase of your life's journeys. What lies ahead of you is unknown, and you will be faced with many opportunities to influence not only your own future, but that of those around you, those people that are important to you, and those issues that you truly care about. Now, these ideals of importance may be social, they may be political, or they may simply be personal. And whatever that issue is, whatever is important to you, find your voice and let it be heard. But let it be heard in a constructive manner, with careful forethought and analysis, and yet with a conviction that comes from your heart. Be a voice of difference. Your time is now, and your world is your palette. Martin Luther King said so eloquently, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about the things that matter." Don't be silent. And the human voice is a powerful force in the trajectory of our world. How you use that voice to influence change determines not only how others react to you, but the reactions to your passion. And many times the power of the spoken word carries indomitable weight in the conviction of your message. Maya Angelou may have said it best when she said, "Words mean more than what is set down on paper. It takes the human voice to infuse them with deeper meaning." Use your human voice to provide deep meaning to your conviction. So if you're struggling with the notion of you possibly affecting huge, meaningful change in the world based on your passions, remember this. A drop creates a ripple that disturbs the calm. You may be one person, but if others are inspired by your actions, they might simply follow your example. Or it may be as simple as this, spoken by Albert Einstein. "Nothing that I can do will change the structure of the universe, but maybe by raising my voice, I can help the greatest of all causes, goodwill among men and peace on earth." So, go find your voice. So as I close my comments to you, the class of 2018, as a dad, I must offer a brief comment to a certain graduate who was incredibly special to me. I promised her I would not embarrass her. Well, I already did that. Madison, your mom and I are so very proud of you. You took an incredible leap of faith and became a proud aviator. Please know, Madison, that one of the greatest honors of my life will take place in just a few minutes when I get to hand you your Sycamore High School diploma. Well done, young lady. So finally, in a matter of moments, graduates, you will accept this diploma. It signifies more than your completion of your graduation requirements. It represents your permanent admission ticket, your permanent place within the Sycamore family. You will forever be a proud alum of Sycamore High School. Carry it with pride, honor it always. Please know that your Sycamore family will always be there for you to cheer for you, support you, and raise you up. Never, ever hesitate to ask. So class of 2018, enjoy this moment. This is your moment of grand accomplishment. As your superintendent, I am so very proud of you and for how you have represented your district. You have made us all better for how you've achieved, how you've performed, how you've competed, and for how you have served. Please accept my thanks and appreciation on behalf of the entire Sycamore family. You have made us proud. Go find your voice, go make your mark, and forever. Go Aves! So now it is my privilege to present our 12th Distinguished Alumni Award. The Distinguished Alumni is an individual whose life is an example of the Sycamore mission, which includes educating the whole person and preparing students for success in a global society. This person also contributes extraordinarily to his or her profession and or community, and impacts Sycamore schools through direct service to the district or has had an impact on students by leading through example. And it is with pride I present to you this year's distinguished alumnus, Mr. Mitch Barnes. Come on up, let me say a few words. I'd like to say just a few words about Mr. Barnes. He's a Sycamore High School graduate, 1981, and now is the CEO of the TV ratings giant, Nielsen. Mitch oversees over 46,000 employees worldwide. His family has roots in Sycamore that is extensive. As a matter of fact, Mitch's dad, Howard Barnes, was a longtime teacher, administrator at Sycamore schools, including being the principal at Sycamore High School. During high school, Mitch loved math and worked as a busboy at Montgomery Inn. After high school, Mitch graduated from Miami University as a finance major, and he went on to work in the marketing research department at P&G, then at a small firm in Cincinnati called Basis, which was eventually acquired by Nielsen. Mitch has lived and worked around the world. He's worked in Brussels, Chicago, Shanghai, and New York. He obtained his MBA in 2011 and rose to the position of CEO of Nielsen in 2014. And through it all, he still calls Sycamore home. His wife Sharon of 32 years is from Montgomery, and the two were actually married at Sycamore Presbyterian Church in 1986, and they have three children. Ladies and gentlemen, our 2018 Sycamore Community School Distinguished Alumnus, Mr. Mitch Barnes.
Hey, class of 2018, I'm really excited to share a few words with you because, yeah, I've been a Sycamore aviator since birth. My father's name was Howard Barnes. When he was just 22 years old, he began his career at Sycamore. And as was mentioned, he was a science teacher, a coach, junior high principal. He was principal of the senior high, and he finished his career at Sycamore as assistant superintendent of schools. So you can imagine, as I was growing up, it seemed like every part of my life was somehow connected to Sycamore. We were always at the school, not just for class, you know, for sports, for events, concerts, you name it. My family, we had two cars. One was green, the other was yellow. But you know, in our house, green and gold, right? Green and gold. Ironically, when I was in high school, one of my best friends did not go to Sycamore. He went to another school nearby. But eventually, he found his way to Sycamore, where he's been a math teacher for 30 years. He is still, to this very day, one of my closest friends. I know him as Randy, but you might know him as Mr. Lothrop. So you see, I was born into Sycamore. I grew up a member of the Sycamore family, and the connection continues for me to this very day. Since graduating from Sycamore in 1981, I've traveled to over 60 countries around the world. I've lived in 11 different places on three different continents. But I've always felt fortunate to be able to say that I'm from here, that I grew up here. I'm from Cincinnati. I went to Sycamore. My wife is from here. We have three kids who were born here. I'm still guided by the same basic values I learned growing up here. I've never let go of my Sycamore ties, and they've never held me back. In fact, it's been quite the opposite. I've taken them with me all through my life, and they've carried me a long, long way. In class of 2018, I hope the same, the very same, for all of you too. Before I close, I want to just share five short little sayings that I learned back in my Sycamore days. Each is a combination of truth and humor, and they provided me with invaluable guidance all throughout my life. And I hope at least one of these might be useful to you too. Okay? Here they are. Number one, if you can't be on time, be early. Look, I know life's hectic, and it can be difficult to be on time all the time. It's actually easier to just be early. It's a good way to impose discipline on yourself, and it's a great way to show respect to others. If you can't be on time, be early. Number two, all you can do is all you can do. Believe it or not, this saying comes from someone named Carl Haverkamp, and he was a custodian at Sycamore Junior High School when I was a student there. His saying was the 1970s version of, it is what it is, right? But Mr. Haverkamp's version was better, because it begs the question, have you done everything that you can? Have you done all that you can do? Have you given it your very best? If not, then do. But if so, then rest in that assurance. I've quoted Mr. Haverkamp hundreds of times over the years. Trust me, most often to myself. In fact, I can still see him, you know, leaning on his broom, looking at me saying, all you can do is all you can do. Number three, when you have a choice, take both. One of the keys to life is knowing when to stand in the intersection of seemingly opposing interests and resist the temptation to choose. Often, the better answer is to live in the tension between the two, seeking the right balance of both. So next time you're presented with the choice, consider choosing both. Number four, don't let your principles get in the way of doing what's right. I got this one from my dad. And look, I know at first it can seem a little confusing, but give it a chance. Think it through. This one's been consistently helpful to me all through my life, even though I think my dad originally meant it as a joke. The basic message here is be pragmatic, not dogmatic. Use your head and think through the principles, of course, but in the end, listen to your heart and do what's right. And the last one, number five, this one's also from my dad. The faster you move, the slower time passes, the longer you live, right? My dad loved this stupid little saying. He'd use this one on me, and then with a total deadpan look on his face, he would say, you know, that's the theory of relativity. And I'd say, yeah, Dad, I know. Because I went to a fantastic school with fantastic teachers. I graduated from Sycamore.
At this time, Mr. Doug Mader, our principal, will unveil a portrait of Mr. Barnes that has his name engraved on it. And this portrait will be on display in the main lobby at Sycamore High School. Please help me in thanking and recognize our 2018 distinguished alumnus, Mr. Mitch Barnes.
Now please Turn your attention to the back for Ivana Reyes and Karen Eidelman performing Nobody Knows. Please welcome Caitlin LeBlanc, 2018 Class President, for her student address. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Caitlin LeBlanc, Class of 2018 Class President. Today, several people have stood at this podium and talked about how amazing our class is. Because, let's face it, we've had countless accomplishments during the past 4 years. However, before we can officially graduate from Sycamore High School, the class of 2018 would like to take a few minutes out of our morning to thank three groups of people who have helped make all of this possible. First of all, parents. We want to thank you for encouraging us to be the best versions of ourselves. While we might not have always shown it, we are grateful that you set high expectations and challenged us to reach them. And when our own parents just don't get it, we are thankful for the guidance of our friends' parents. For example, I think of the Moskowitz parents who taught us all not to fall apart during life's challenges, but rather stay strong, set goals, and move forward. Secondly, we would like to thank our PTO. You worked tirelessly to plan events such as Senior Halloween, Senior Night, After Prom, and the Senior Cookout. These events helped us make memories that will last a lifetime, and they also helped us grow closer as a class. For example, one senior remarked after the main event that it was the most positive experience he had ever had during high school. We would be remiss to fail to publicly thank you for all you've done, So, with great admiration, we thank you for your endless support. Finally, we can't leave out our amazing teachers. You aren't just educators. You are also cherished mentors. Year after year, you have shown us that you care deeply about each and every one, and you have invested your lives into helping us live our lives to their fullest. I know that each graduating senior can name at least one teacher who has positively impacted his or her life for the better. You've empathized with us when we've had a bad day, and you've celebrated our successes with heartfelt enthusiasm. In the end, we are thankful you've had our backs during both our best and worst days. In addition to our classroom teachers, we would like to thank our class advisor, Ms. Knatzer, who has been with us since our freshman year and has done more for the class of 2018 than most of us even realize. We're also thankful for the class of 2018 administrator, Dr. Mack, who worked tirelessly to support us and also organize many events such as the Senior Service Day and this graduation ceremony. Finally, we would like to thank our student council advisors, Ms. Korchok and Mr. Vohr, who are basically a mom and dad for every student council member. Teachers and administrators have often said that the class of 2018 is one of the most unified to ever graduate from Sycamore High School. All in all, we care about each other, and we are unified. Together, we've celebrated the accomplishments of our artists, athletes, musicians, National Merit Scholars, and scientists, as well as many others who have done amazing things throughout high school. On the other hand, we've also supported those who have endured the disappointment of a college rejection, the darkness of a mental health crisis, or the challenge of a physical setback. Through the ups and downs, we have supported each other, and we have been supported by a village of adults who care about us. In conclusion, the class of 2018 is sincerely grateful to all of you who have made this possible. Because of you, we are fully prepared to pursue our dreams and also help others pursue their dreams along the way. Thank you, parents, PTO members, and teachers.
Now please welcome Senior Jenna Bao with her student address, Our Story.
Good morning, family, friends, class of 2018. I've always been enamored with storytelling. And don't worry, we're not here today to discuss the Odyssey, or at least not directly. And we're also not here to talk about Snapchat stories, even though I'm sure those have captured their fair share of our epics. Rather, I want to share a classic. Once upon a time, in a land far, far away, the class of 2018 sat in an auditorium and heard an address. Now, at that point, we weren't in caps and gowns. Rather, we were dressed about as well as freshmen can be, and we had to look good for our first day photos. Our backpacks were stuffed with 7 binders, all of which we were sure we would need just to survive Sycamore High School, this mysterious forest in which we were made to be lost. Since then, a magical transformation has taken place. And as much good as puberty has done for most of us, I'm not talking about a Princess and the Frog type transformation. Instead, I am referring to the way that every single member of this class is a wholly different person today than they were sitting in that auditorium. We went from the kid in the chorus of Shrek to the lead in Into the Woods. From being cut off JV to becoming varsity team captain, from wondering how we would ever finish our world history reading assignments to crafting capstone projects and writing 3,000 word research papers. We went from being terrified at the prospect of high school to having conquered it. And that's not to say that it always felt like a fairy tale. We fell into traps until we learned how to avoid them or to escape. We faced setbacks that we never could have expected. We fought hard to slay our dragons, and sometimes we still got burned, but we always had our parents, teachers, and one another to help us get back up for round 2. It's these experiences that have allowed this transformation to occur, and that have prepared us for the next chapter. Because, of course, our stories are far from over. If anything, this feels more like the end of the beginning. And if I've learned anything about plot, that means that the best part is yet to come. To be fair, the plot twists and pitfalls are only going to get trickier from here. But I have to say, I'm confident that each and every one of us is ready to take on those challenges. I can say that because after working on the Leaf since freshman year, if there's one thing I've learned besides how to slip shsleaf.org into every conversation, it is that this is one incredible class, and we've had a unique and extraordinary 4 years. After all, we are the only class that has been blessed with both park and air testing, the first to begin and end our journeys with Mr. Mater as principal. We saw our school adapt and transform with Ace Bell, the hub, the tragedy of the smoothie bar. We served our communities with innovation and dedication and raised thousands of dollars for causes near and dear to our hearts, working on Fashion for the Cure, United for Uganda, Operation Give Back, Live for Liz, Windows for Hope, and so much more. We saw society change with Black Lives Matter, a new president, the death of Vine, and the birth of Fiona, with the Women's March, the Me Too movement, March for Our Lives. And as the world around us whirled with tumultuous elections and natural disasters and social movements, we not only excelled as students, but got involved with all of the above to act on our passions. I have been honored to share these stories, and I am more honored to be graduating with all of you here today. Happy endings are overrated, so for now, I'll just say that I cannot wait to see how our stories unfold from here. Thank you, congratulations, and go Waves.
Ladies and gentlemen, members of the staff, Board of Education, district office members, I present to you for graduation the Sycamore High School class of 2018.
Sarah Abraham, Elena Ann Berry, Gina Ruggeri, Noah Adler Abrahamson, Caitlin Elizabeth LeBlanc, Alyssa Diane Allen, Linka Iba, Angelina Rose Amedio, Scott Bowers Allison, Benjamin Jackson Armstrong, Thomas Halloway Anderson, Noah Lee Atkins, Jacob Harrison Arno, Anne Catherine Baldwin, Sydney Christine Barr, Sophie Erin Bala, Emma Mira Balk, Brecca Lee Banner, Kyle Richard Ballman, Christopher Michael Banzoff, Kelsey Kid Boudreau, and she had to leave, Olivia Shirley Banzoff, Michael Alexander Samways, Maggie Elizabeth Newman, Emma Jane Basselman, Chloe Bell Anderson Isles, Nicholas Matthew Allen, Julia Marie Wapham, Jenna Shu Bao. Bryson Robert Bates. Brandon Allen Bond. Waleed Talal Bawazir. Andrea Michelle Bell. Nicholas Adam Bell. Christopher John Bemis. Zachary Andrew Berger. Alexander Kenneth Bertok. Drake R. Blaney. Caroline Helen Blood. Kira Elizabeth Bolt. Jonathan Amadeus Bothan. Skylar Morgan Botcher. Garrett Lane Boyd. Ann Watkins Brabender. Natalie Elise Brinkman. Leslie Rebecca Brown. Maximilian Joseph Bruggeman. Zoe Madeline Buggy. Alexander Stewart Burton. Christian Cheyenne Bird. Paula Consales Calvo. Bethany Lynn Carr. Levin Henry Carr. Terrell Andre Cash. Madison Riley Kelly. Ivana Ray Reyes. Anita Flora Pan. Jen June Chen. Yi Chen. Ashwin Pratheep Chidambaram. Emily May Chen. Ethan Sashoon Choi. Aditi Susita Chunder. Taylor Rose Close. Sarah Ruth Cohen. Adasia Brianna Cole. Genesis Combs. Michael Joseph Cooper. Elizabeth Grace Creech. Jack Royce Creek. Piante Ramon Crew Jr. Matthew Brian Crone. Benjamin John Darple. Rishav Raj Dasgupta. Gary Howard Austin Davidson. Maya Carly Davidson. Gabrielle Nicole Davis. Jaslyn Sarah Davis Johnson. Theodore Emerson Day. Maximilian Deck. Natalie Taylor DeMarks. Megan Kathleen DiGiovanna. Christopher James DeBrosi. Karen Esther Eidelman Sedinko. Constance Kenna Kavinsky. Catherine Elaine Dunn. Audrey Joe Divad. Olivia Jane Adelstein. Jordan Samuel Edwards. Elizabeth Ashley Eilers. Jacob Noam Englander. Kendricks Olivia Eppert. Sydney Marie Evans. Tyreek Terrell Evans. Stephen Daniel Fang. Taylor Nicole Ferris. Jessica Clay Fair. Kyle Dennis Fair. Thea Elizabeth Ferdinand. Grant William Fisher. Noah Joseph Fleggy. Lila Michelle Foley. John Dean Foles. Madison Lee Forstoffel.
Absalon Michael Frakes. Abigail Lee Hosfeld. Preston Tucker Franklin. Allison Marie Fredette. Lily Lynn Freiberg. Dylan Joseph Fricky. Alex Gregory Finley. Albert Jack Fryman. Alexander Stephen Galbraith. Sophia Marie Gallion. Gavin Shane Garrett. Oliver David Garrett. Joseph Edward Hope. Rohith Gald Gatu. David Clayton Gibbs III. Sarah Elizabeth Gilmore. Shannon Connaughton Glass. David Godar. Zoe Alexandra Goldenberg. Alonzo Gonzalez Rivas. Drew Adam Gordon. Hallie Paige Gordon. Meredith Sue Gottliebson. Megan Sue Gould. Alexis Margaret Grannon. Alan Marcus Gray. Zaria Margaret Gray. Tamira Monet Green. Jacob X. Grega. Jacqueline Jaunan Marie Grega. Charles Schuster Griffith IV. Giovanni Soleil Grisby. Jacob Michael Gruba. Kevin Rain Galloway. Benjamin Tate Goodyear. Gustav Todd Guckenberg. Yasmin Gadira. Timothy James Guth. Bryson Matthew Gwynn. Chelsea LaRae Haley. Christine Lynn Hanish. Griffin Abraham Harris. Charles Robert Hart. Jacob Andrew Hasselbeck. Joshua Abel Honert. Kylie Elise Nicole Hawkins. Daniel Joseph Helker. Byron James Heist. Anna Weiwei Helker. Peter James Henderson. Ty Douglas Hendricks. Caitlin Paige Herzog. Bennett Joseph Hine. Mayabi Hibino. Kalis Elijah Wayne Hicks. John Logan Hilzebeck. Grant Richard Heinlein. Asa Judah Hodrick. Brenna Elliott McCullough Hollingsworth. Sarah Ann Marie Holtz. Stephanie Yuan Hong. Ori Joseph Graff. Chad Severin Gallinari. Nadia Abdurrahman Hussein. Heidi Lynn Howell. Olivia Kate Hukalak. Luke Elijah Huffer. Noah Robert Hughes. McKinley May Irving. Matthew David Isaacson. Anthony Jake Isgro. Samuel Benjamin Shai Ishida. Trevor Alexander Jansen. Terrell Montez Jasper. Amanda Nicole Jensen. Fenyi Zheng. Caitlin Lee Zhang. Alexander Cole Johnson. Brianna Leslie Johnson. Jordan Kyle Johnson. Ryan Christine Jones. Sasha Denise Justice. Nir Isaac Kadosh. Joshua Michael Kaiser. Andrew Ryan Kelleher. Kelsey Marie Candle. Mackenzie Christine Candle. Colby Danielle Kaplan. Sydney Elizabeth Kaplan. Brandon Montez Jones Hall. Caroline Michelle Keaton. Samuel Thomas Keller. John Joseph Kelly III. Christian David Kelly. Andrew Riley Kern. Nikhil Kanji Katana. Macy Aline Keys. Neelash Chandra Katana. Emily Claire King. Noah John Kinsinger. Everett Paul Kohinki. Lalitha Lavanya Konda. Noah Richard Kashani. Jacob Daniel Kotzen.
Nathan Allen Kraft. Samuel Bradley Croin. Riley Ann Kurtz. Taylor Ann Kyle. Siyoung Linmoy Lai. William Casey LaRock. Jody Diane Lawson. Josie Gail Leach. Paige Elizabeth Leary. Haesung Lee. Heyoungjun Lee. Hannah Rachel Leonard. Tyson Julius Levy. Joseph Patrick Len Jr. Boyd Brogan Lake. Victor Siangfeng Lim. Jackson Tyler Lippman. Garrett Edward Lockwood. Alexander Arthur Long. Hannah Grace Long. Melinda Nicole Looney Ho. Israel Francisco Lorizana. Mitchell Thomas Lewis. Gina Nicolette Luck. Patricia Rose Luck. Jamin Asher Luke. Jindora Ann Lumpkin. Anina Jane Lundgren. Lauren Ma. Christine Aaron Mackey. Ethan Peter Main. Hasimrian Makad. Jonathan Michael Malik Jr. Jameson Alexander Marksberry. Anne Elizabeth Marsh. Enrique Martin Uri. Lily Marie Martinson. Dylan Patrick Massey. Hunter Alexander Maxfield. Morgan Nicole McAvoy. Julia Lauren McDowell. Connor Charles McGowan. Megan Leslie McMullen. Kate McNamara Marslin. Adam Conrad Meller. Nicole McNamara Marslin. Karen Ashley Malott. Alexa Valerie Melzer. Chase Bradley Merritt. Uliana Meslesky. Elena Michelle Myers. Justin Eisler Miller. Zachary John McMillican. Dominic LaShawn Million Jr. Hajame Minaguchi. Shruti Mishra. Matthew David Mahanahan. David Moskowitz. Jack Carl Moskowitz. Claire Elise Myers. Meera Lakshmi Nadathur. Duji Nadagata. Vini Narayan. Adam Murta. Anna Murta. Vini Narayan. Jordan Alexander Narid. Tristan Scott Neal. Alexander Richard Newberg. Joshua Eric Nickel. Ray Singer Nori. Ireland Grace O'Shea. Ryan Michael Meckes. Adrian Luke Oliver. Maria Cristina Ormaza Palacios. Calliope Rose Osborne. Natalie Michelle Palazzolo. Koosh Pollywall. Ta Lynn Parr. Atitz Patik. Alexandra Marie Patton. Nitin Yadav Paletti. Azaria Kalia Nicole Payne. Haven McKinnon Payne. David Pero Aguilera. Jennifer Nicole Persiani. Jewel Lachey Phillips. Giuseppe Alessandro Panita Ritchie. Jeremy Matthew Pletz, Nathan Scott Powers, James Bynum Pointer, Kendall Maurice Price, Jessica Nicole Provateer, Madeline Louise Piles, Sophia Christina Ramos, Destiny Hope Ramsey, Caitlin Elizabeth Rasulis, Aiden Joseph Reckamp, Emily Morgan Reddy, Kelsey Michelle Reisert, Joseph Benjamin Pulaski, Alexander Charles Reynolds, Justin Warren Reynolds, Ethan Aaron Rice, Quinn Patrick Ryle, Madison Grace Ringer,
Gregory Igor Riven, Brad Leroy Rollins, Jacob Sullivan Rose, Allison Taylor Ross, Alexander Stephen Roth, Siri Yurievich Reuter, Hannah Isabel Rosenson, Kevin Daniel Russell, James Jian Hui Sam, Jared Alexander Sandow, Alexandra Lee Shire, Kyle Anthony Scheel, Ryan Henry Scheel, Madeline Laura Schramm, Kyle Logan Schreiber, Kyle Richard Schroeder, Rebecca Lee Schultz, Leah Richmond Schwartz, Nikhil Saker, Zachary Ryan Sheehan, Ekaterina Alexandrovna Shubina, Azavir Singh, Alexander Joshua Shad, Shariah Barthen Singh, Trevor Heaton Size, Dylan Ross Sleo, Maxime James Sliger, Grace Elizabeth Smallwood, Noah Benjamin Smilg, Emma Elizabeth Smith, Sierra Nicole Smith, Kevin Matthew Snyder, Max Richard Snyder, Jennifer Christina Sorto, John Jack Carlisle Spellman, Rachel Alona Spivak, Catherine Marie Stafira, Catherine Rose Stoutberg, Isabella Jade Stevens, Lily Caitlin Stewart, Elizabeth Mary Catherine Stocker Barrett, Michaela Lynn Stover, Nicole Lynn Stullenberger, Eve Ducidy Stuntbeck, Autumn Hope Sturgill, Emma Grace Solstead, Carly Elise Sutton, Benjamin Knight Swart, Matthew Chase Swartz, Melinda Claire Sweeney, Duncan Patrick Stewart, Zed Mohib Syed, Raymond Kai Saliga, Abigail Taylor Teagarden, Grayson Mayer Thornberry, Luke Patrick Tinbarge, Evan Alexander Timofeyev, Alexander Shea Thornberry, David Samuel Tochterman, Austin James Tornator, Daniel John Torres, Bailey Renee Truitt, Jacob Edgar Truitt, Jackson Matthew Trumpy, Patrick Khalid Tuweme, Ryan Joseph Tufts, Andrew Donald Turner, Eileen Simone Tyler, Bowie Hinang Ook, Michael Edward Underwood Jr., Lexi Margot Van Johnson, Andrea Lee Vaughn, Kelsey Teresa Ventura, Amelie Vermusen, Autumn Deborah Vest, Leitong Vuong, Nicholas James Walker, Kiri Wang, Jewel Bailey Watkins, Matthew Connor Watsek, Liam Thomas Wells, Catherine Anna Wenzel, Joshua Thomas Wessinger, Jason Theodric Westbrook, Courtney Winter White, Julian Christopher Wilkerson, Myron Orlando Williams Jr., Catherine Elizabeth Willis, Kelly Margaret Winkfeld, Bryce Lynn Winnestaffer, Jin Wu, Matthew Joshua Woodside, Jordan Leon Wright, Samuel James Wyatt, Michael Siyoung, Shuhan Young, Sivan Yarki, Esma Yinzil, Gabrielle Halon Yun, Nathan Weeyong Zhang, Yinjin Zhang, Skylar Elizabeth Ziegler, Itamar Zamora, Noah Kyle Gast.
Please turn your attention to the back where Emma Balk and Constance Kavinsky will be performing Where Do We Go From Here?
do we go from here? Now that you are standing here with me, after all, there's more to life than holding you. What's gonna happen?
I don't know, but what's gonna happen when we go from here? That we are sitting side by side, after all there's more to life than we can see.
Will there be troubles?
I don't know, but will there be sweet things?
I hope so.
Will there be time to keep on dreaming once this dream?
Please keep your attention on the back as the select ensemble will sing a song of farewell. Mr. Mader, Mr. Forstoffel, members of the board and the Sycamore community, the class of 2018 gladly accepts these diplomas.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to introduce to you the graduates of Sycamore High School. Thank you.
Yeah.